Completing a Stuart triple expansion engine, part 3. Working on the valve gear and playing with the timing for the high pressure cylinder. On this engine, the eccentric sheaves are held to the crankshaft with very small grub screws like this one. I'm changing the slot headed grub screw for the Allen key type. But this is only a temporary measure. When I start to rebuild the engine for real, I'm going to use what in my opinion is a much better way to hold the eccentric sheaves tightly to the crankshaft. The grub screws are not really the problem, they are actually okay. It's a part of the eccentric sheave into which this grub screw fits. The metal is not thick enough. The basic workmanship on this engine is pretty good. As you can see, the expansion link slides freely from side to side. Now I'm going to initially set the timing, so I need to have a look at what the slide valve is doing inside the high pressure cylinder. Once I remove the pin and the die block, I can swing the assembly out of the way. But in this case I've removed the entire valve gear for the high pressure cylinder, and I'm going to clean up the front face using a piece of wet to dry sandpaper and some oil. In the fullness of time, and much later on in the series, I will be doing some more work on the valve gear. This very thin collar around the eccentric sheave was originally fitted with a 7BA slot head grub screw. And in this clip I'm re-threading the hole to allow me to use a 6BA Allen type grub screw. Once again, in my opinion, this is still not strong enough. As you can see, the wall of the eccentric sheave at this point is quite thin. And here it is again with the Allen type grub screw fitted. The normal method that I use to clamp the eccentric sheave to the crankshaft involves drilling a hole in the centre of the eccentric strap underneath, which will allow access to a larger and longer Allen grub screw, for which a hole will be drilled and threaded through the eccentric from the outside right down to where the crankshaft is. The next thing I need to do is have a look at the slide valve. I'll speed this clip up because it did take an extraordinarily long time. Each time I removed a nut, I had to re-thread it partially back on the stud so I could get it out of the nut spinner. There are one or two problems on this engine with sheared bolts, and this was the first one. When I tried to undo the bolt that held the high-pressure cylinder's exhaust pipe in place, it wouldn't move. It was completely solid and trapped in the hole, and it just sheared off. Luckily, the bolt was only a mild steel bolt, so it was quite easy to drill it out, very accurately in the centre, and re-thread it 7BA. This is what I'm doing at the moment. Once I'd drilled out the bolt, I stopped drilling. I didn't want to go all the way through the cylinder and come out the other side. I think I know what the problem is and why the bolt sheared off. This hole communicates with one of the steamways inside the cylinder. And now I'm getting the feel for this engine, I can see that the builder was having a bit of trouble setting the valve timing. So this engine will have run on compressed air frequently in an attempt to do this. And some of the remaining moisture in the steamway rusted this small bolt in place. It's not going to be a problem in future, as I intend to use studs fitted with nuts. I've temporarily put a bolt back in place because there is an air leak from somewhere inside the steam chest to the outside world via this hole. And then, with an advanced case of paranoia, I removed the steel bolt in case this rusted in place overnight. I know it's highly unlikely because this engine's been sat around for the last 26 years or so, but just in case I fitted a brass screw. The question is, where is the air leak coming from? I'm pretty sure that it's coming from the steamway that goes from the steam chest port face to the cylinder edge. It's important when building steam engines to make sure that you have the depth stop on your drilling machine set so you don't drill the holes too deeply. In this clip, I'm having a close look at the expansion link just to make sure that it completely clears the valve fork, and it does, all the way at both sides. Once again, the engineering standards are very good. The first thing I would now do is set the approximate position of the eccentric sheave on the crankshaft. And to start with, I would set the eccentric sheave's position so that the large lobe on the eccentric is at 90 degrees to the crank web, pretty much as you see here. You have to start somewhere. The next part of the job is to make sure that the slide valve uncovers the steam inlet ports equally at both ends. You must only ever do this whilst moving in one direction, and I'm holding the expansion link manually in the correct position, as this part of the valve gear is not complete. I thought it would be a good time, as I'd got the steam chest cover off, to clean it up on a piece of wet or dry sandpaper. It will need more work than this. In this clip you can see something that is bothering me. And I'm really not being OCD on this because I do not have OCD. I'm a bit obsessive, but I don't have the C part of it. But what I can see, pardon the pun, is that this machine recess in the centre of the steam chest cover is not in the middle. This bothers me and will need to be rectified. Pretty much in the same way as this. Look at how much thread is sticking out of the nut in the centre and at the right hand side. I don't know what's gone wrong here, the builder must have been having a bad day, we all have them. I really can't live with this, it's very visible. As you can see, the engine runs okay. It's still only running on the high pressure cylinder, but it will only run in one direction. I haven't taken into consideration the 30 degree offset of the eccentric sheaves, which are made as a pair. I'm very concerned about the oil supply, so every time I run the engine, I inject some oil into the other cylinders that don't have an oil feed. In this series so far, I've mentioned quite a few times that the workmanship standard is good. To say that the steam chest cover is not fitted using all the nuts, the oil leaks are not that bad really. I thought it would be a good idea though to fit all of them. At least there's plenty of oil getting to the high pressure cylinder. When the engine's completed and piped together, any lubricating oil fed in with the compressed air or the steam will arrive at the high pressure cylinder, then go out of that into the intermediate and from that into the low pressure cylinder. But until the engine gets to that point, I will still keep feeding some oil into the other cylinders. This is how I normally set valve timing. I use my ear. I feed in some compressed air at low pressure, then I slowly rotate the crankshaft in the direction of rotation it's supposed to be going, and I need to hear this hissing noise just as the crank pin is about to go over top dead centre, and also when it's about to go over the bottom dead centre too. I do exactly the same with the reversing lever in the opposite direction, obviously turning the crankshaft in the reverse direction as well. Then once again, by adjusting the position of the eccentric sheave on the crankshaft, I can get a compromised situation where it's quite good in both directions. On this engine, the eccentric sheaves are machined as a pair, with a 30 degree offset on the high pressure cylinder and a 15 degree offset for the other two cylinders. Personally, I prefer it if each eccentric is fully adjustable on its own. Something simple now, I'm removing the grub screw from the flywheel. It was held in place by a slot-headed grub screw and I don't like that, so instead I'm removing the slot-headed grub screw fully and I'm going to replace it with an Allen key type grub screw. I think it's a better way of doing it than having one of these. Now it's time to see if the engine runs in both directions. It is of course still running on just the high pressure cylinder, and I will tweak it some more along with the other two cylinders in due course. That's it for this episode. Stay healthy, thanks for watching, and I hope you found it useful. Please take the time to visit my main Steam Models website and click on the section of the website that says video playlists, and by doing that you can find other videos that you may like to watch. And by using the playlists, you can actually watch the videos back to back.